So my question is, how does it feel to be part of people's lives that they want to go back to your work and pass that along to younger generations?
Yeah, I mean, it's cool. They actually did The Little Mermaid at the Hollywood Bowl. I guess it was about
a couple years ago.
Yeah, a little over a couple years ago. Which is fun because the bowl is filled, and it's filled with people who just love the movie. So it's an easy audience in its own way. But it was a great experience. I think for me, it was one of the first sort of waking up, which I guess I should be aware of, but that all these kids, all these people that were kids, little kids when the movie first came out, have now grown up. And a lot of them are here, and that should be obvious, but I don't think I really quite thought of that way before.
Yeah, that's true. But you know, we're here because we've loved Disney and Disney animation for so long, and now, you know, it has been a big part of our lives. So now we're just kind of carrying on the tradition, and to have our films now be embraced by audiences and people is a good feeling. I mean, I'm very thankful for that.
Usually these mythological creatures are not represented in a benevolent way, usually sirens and creatures that.
Mm-hmm. No, it was still the Hans Christian Andersen fairy tale was the inspiration. Mm-hmm. And she's very sympathetic in the Hans Christian Andersen fairy tale.
But it's very different.
It's very different, and it's very sad, and it ends very, very sad, and the mermaid dies in the end. So we've sort of really put a lot into trying to sort of reinvent that story in a way that would kind of give it a happy ending, but a satisfying happy ending. But in his story, she was sympathetic, I think. So I know there are certainly sirens and darker versions of mermaids in other interpretations, but that really came from his original inspiration.
Mm-hmm. At what point does the character become alive for you? Is there a specific point when you stop thinking about the character as a concept and you start thinking about the character as a person?
Yeah, well, that's a big part of my job. I mean, so I've gotten, you know, I see what the story is from the directors. I'm getting their input of their ideas. I'm hearing Jodie Benson's voice interpretations as she is acting out the character, and I'm bringing all those elements together. So for me, when I see her on screen moving as early as a pencil test, doesn't have to be in full color, I'm starting to see a character, a real, you know, believable character on screen. And to me, you know, seeing it in color is just, you know, the icing on the cake. So it's got to be there, as even in the pencil tests, they have to be believable characters.
But there is a magical moment, and it's sometimes hard to define, because even when you start with the writing and the storyboarding and it's all like pre-production, and the character, you know what you want the character to be, mm-hmm. and you have these definite ideas, but she's not alive yet, or whatever the character is, they're not alive yet, and then there is sort of a magical point where suddenly they are alive, and you don't even think of the process, even directing the film. It just becomes like what they would do. It just becomes natural. It's like as if they really existed. And it's really cool when that happens. And it happens differently, I think, with different characters. But it's always a really cool thing when that happens.
Awesome. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.